You've already done the hard work by creating the Power BI model. And now it's time for the fun part. I'm going to show you how easy it is to create beautiful interactive reports in Power BI. Keep watching. The whole purpose of this exercise has been to step through these three phases and go end to end. Now, we have spent most of the time in the author portion so far, and rightly so. That is the heavy lifting. That's where the smarts are. That's right where you're combining data from multiple sources, bringing that in, clean shape transform in the query engine as needed, and then you define your relationships, define your measures, and that's essentially all of your business logic, right? What's important to your business. You define those metrics, and now you're ready to publish and consume. So by the end of this portion, what we're going to end up with is an underlying report and a dashboard published on PowerBI.com and ready to be consumed by any user who wants to connect to it. So we get back to our model, and this is exactly where we had left off. We had some debug pivots here, which I've, debug elements there, which we had just thrown in to see how the measures were working. Now I've taken them off, so we have a blank slate here. Again, this is your Power BI desktop interface. So it has all the measures we have defined so far, and now we're in the reporting view and ready to build our first report. This is what we are trying to build, or something similar. It doesn't have to be exactly that. Certainly, if you're following steps along, feel free to be creative. And visualization is certainly part art and part science. But we'll use that as a template. And let's start by just putting a text box for a label there. We'll say BenchWorks, perfect. Let's make it larger. It's probably big enough. And I'm going to resize this element. All right, great. So, BenchWorks. And now I'm going to add an image. So, again, in the ribbon right next to text box, there's an image button. I'm going to click on that. And actually, I placed it in my temp folder. So, I have my logo right here. I open that, and then I can resize it as I see fit. Perfect. Okay, that looks great. Now I'm going to add some high-level elements. So you're going to see this pattern that I follow. It's a very simple pattern. And again, visualization, don't think that you have to be fancy, you have to make it look really shiny. Truth be told, and if you read the best practices, simpler the better, right? Because they're more usable and less distraction. So we'll, in further modules, later modules, we're going to go a lot deeper into visualizations and best practices. Now, visualization, I have to say, this whole interface, it's got 1,000 tips and tricks in here, kind of like Excel visualizations. We're not going to cover them end to end. So this is not going to be a comprehensive guide on everything you can do around visualizations, but we're going to show you some basics, show you some best practices, and get you up and running. And from that point on, you can pick up tips and tricks as you go. All right, great. So let's start. So again, certainly for the first round, we're going to keep things simple. So we'll start with high-level data. So we have, I think I did this earlier. So let's add a filter. So again, our budget data is only calendar year 2016. So I'm going to drag in that as a page filter. You can also add it as a report filter. Now remember, report filter is going to apply to all the pages if I did have additional pages. But for now, I just have one page, so page filter is sufficient. 2016, that's set. And I'm going to start bringing in my elements. I'm going to start by clicking sales. And again, this is like, you being in a shopping mart. What do you want, right? The heavy lifting has been done. All the core measures have been defined. And now you're just picking that elements and dropping them in your cart. So sales, and I'm going to choose the card type. So this one is a bold, very bold visual, big numbers, and works great in Power BI, especially as you'll see later for pinning elements to the dashboard. So, all right, so I got the first element. Now, I don't quite like the 16 million. That's not enough granularity, so we're going to change that. So remember, the first tab here is fields, and the next one is format. Analytics, we're kind of wait for that one. So we're going to talk about that later. But for now, I'm going to go to Format and Data Label. And the display, if you hover over it, actually it doesn't show anything, which is weird. But display is really, it's saying, hey, auto, which is what it's doing right now. It determines by itself. Well, I'm just going to say none. And you're going to see this in action. So after none, it's showing me the dollar value instead of showing 16M. So this one is good. Let's make it just right size. Perfect. And I'm just going to Control C, Control V. So, and you can also use the buttons over here, copy, paste. Got four elements because I know what I want here, and there are other buttons here to format to equally distribute it. Maybe let's do that right now. I'm gonna say distribute horizontally. Great. So this one I wanted to show budget, and I can just drag over it. Great, that's done. And this one I want to show variance. Again, I'm gonna drag over it. That's done. I was showing variance. And the last one I want to show variance percentage. Done. Actually, maybe I will space these slightly here. Again, part art, part science. You don't have to exactly follow every mouse movement that I'm doing. Just follow it in general. All I'm trying to do is show high-level numbers up there. So actually, I'm going to keep going, build the elements, and then I'm going to spend the time to tweak it visually to make sure it looks good. All right, so I got the high-level elements. Perfect. Let's bring in sales again. And by the way, you notice I can kind of drag elements there. If I select, if I unselect everything, so I click on white space and I bring in something, it creates a new element as well. Picks a default visual that it thinks it makes best sense. Or I can, of course, drag elements over like this. So I can drag budget on that. Or you can drag it to the fields over here. So either way, take your pick, doesn't really matter. And again, this part is really just playful. This is just us kind of playing with these things. Quite discoverable, quite easy to learn, I would say, especially when you compare to the work we were doing in data model. So we got sales and budget, and then I'm going to add product category in the axis, and I'm gonna allow for drill down by embedding subcategory within there. Let's change that to a bar chart. And I'm going to change the sorting so it's alphabetical. You'll see why. So sort by category. And I'm going to click again, Z to A, to change it alphabetical. So now it's accessories, bikes, and clothing. So sales and budget by category. And I'm going to copy paste this element again. Because here, instead of sales and budget, I would like to show variance. So kind of side by side. All right, let's add some color to it. So variance, so this already allows drill down, so somebody can go accessories, drill down, and see the sales and budget for each subcategory within accessories, or right click on this, and say, all right, well, so this gives you a slightly different view, variance, and you can see tires and tubes. The variance is about $10,000. Okay, so we're back here. Let's add some color to it. And we're gonna use this color saturation field. So you notice here, there's variance and color saturation, and I'm gonna make the color saturation use the same feel as well. So you notice it added some color up here, but I'm going to tweak that, play with that. So I'm going to go to formats, data colors, and minimum I'm going to choose red, and for maximum I'm not going to choose bright green. I'm just going to choose this light green. Okay, good. So I'm going to leave it there, and let's just play with it, see how things look. So if you drill down on accessories, this one is really negative, so it's a deep red, and the others are kind of milder shade of the color. Okay, we're good here. Let's again copy paste this element, and now I'm gonna remove category and subcategory, change this to a line chart, and add my calendar month to it. Axis. All right, looks great. So that gives me a trend. And again, this is similar to how I have done here. I have let them compare sales and budget side by side. Essentially, that gives you a view of, hey, who has the biggest chunk of things, right? So accessories, you can see that helmets and tires and tubes are the biggest ones. And variants really tells you that, hey, who's not doing well, right? So you can see, well, in this case, helmets and tires tube both are not doing that great. So we're gonna try something similar here. Again, Control C, Control V. And instead of sales and budget, I'm gonna bring in variants. Variants, great. And I'm gonna change that to a column chart. And I'm gonna add some color here. Again, I'm gonna put variance in color saturation just the way we had done it for this graph earlier. Just go into here, data colors, minimum is red, and this one is kind of light green. And lastly, I'm just gonna throw in my top products and top customers. So I got sales, and we'll change this to a table. Make it slightly bigger. And let's start with top customers. So get full name, change the order. There we go, full name sales. And I'm going to turn off the totals, because total really 16473, I'm already seeing it here. It doesn't add any value. So I'm gonna turn off the total, go to here, general, turn totals off, they're gone. And while I'm here, let's give it a title. So let's turn on the title, and I'm gonna say top customers. Make that a little bigger. And I'm gonna Control C, Control V, grab that, so make it a little smaller. And instead of customers, I'm gonna grab product. Go and fix the title. Instead of saying top customers, now I'm just gonna say top products.
Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.